Everyone, in this tutorial I am going to use break or continue statement, and for this I am going to select put a command button, and I am going to use part 12 and change the label part 12. And I am going to use two strings, delete the label, it's unnecessary, use it white, and select another. Put away the label. Clear and make it white and use a decoration. And use it, resize it, and it is okay. Now what I am going to do in this tutorial, I am going to put the digits as a string, because it is text box, it only accepted the strings, and I am going to use a generate callback on this icon. I'm going to remove the unnecessary events, and I am going to move it under my callback functions. Control V, and I am going to declare few variables. Char val at 100 element, each element is empty, val 2 of 100, each element is empty, and I am going to, this is what I need. And in this loop, I am going to use a for loop for int I equal 1. It begins from 1, and I less than 11 plus plus I am going to check if I equal 8, break, else I to a integer conversion to a string of I and put it in s, and then a string cat val at with s, and a string cat val 1 with the comma space, and then and after that, after this for loop, we are going to set control P, set control val, and I am going to use in my string 5, put it in a string 5, and I am going to use the val 1, keep control key press. press I key, and I am going to use another for loop with int j equal or equal 1, j less than 11 plus plus j. I am going to use if j equals 3 or j equals 6, use only continue. Otherwise, use the same copy v I to a, put it in s and concatenate with val2 and val2 and the num the text box number 6, and I am going to compile. Select yes. As soon as the index is 8, it's going to break. But in the next time, as soon as the index is 3, it doesn't do anything, only continue with the rest of the indexes. And when it reaches 6, it doesn't do anything and it's going to continue with the rest of integers. Okay, it's work. But here in part 1, part 11, I have used this time, and I am going to complete it. This one. Instead of quality, I am going to use boolean, which is defined here, boolean, and use true. And I am going to use here true, and I am going to in number 11, I am going to put it. Number 11, yes, here I am going to use an if my info 1 dot doesn't work, it doesn't as I wanted, is equal true, then message quality true. I am only check if it's work or not. Okay, you can use it here, and you can change the boolean here. You can use it false, and you can use a variable boolean b, and here, down here, you can use it in part 11. You can use it b is true, then it works. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial. We are going through the rest of structures, and see you later.